like TT said, first of all, I'd like to thank TT and the Fuller Craft Museum. This is our third year opening up for the Shades of Yale, and it's an honor. It's always seemed like it's the first time. We're all excited. We're all a little bit nervous. But just to let you know a little bit about Baronezza Project, it's a creative writing program for young women in Brockton, where we use poetry to express ourselves about things that are important to us, things that are happening around our lives, our home, and our community, and in turn try to inspire ourselves and others, basically to have a voice through writing. Before we begin, I just want to ask you guys one little favor. If you hear, these poems are written by the young girls themselves. We write it in the spirit of the moment, so it's all from the heart. So I hope that you'll appreciate it. And if you hear something you like, I want you to go like this. Can we practice, please? So snap for yourselves one time. All right. Thank you very much. I'm going to introduce the girls. First up, we're going to have Diana, Josie, Dara, Leilani, Riza, Elizabeth, and Elena. So these are my girls. We're all different ages, but we come together as one for the sake of poetry. So thank you.
Paperback. For a moment, I got lost. Frisky snowflakes falling on my window. Pine trees swaying back and forth as if they were waving at me. The wind was singing to me, a lullaby of cold, brisk wind. You are in my hands now. I want to hold you and listen to every word you speak of. I want to embrace your every line. My shivering hands are making me lose my place. How about more fluffy marshmallows? It reminds me of the clumsy snowflakes on my window. Perhaps more wood in the fireplace? My feet need a resting place. Hot cocoa in my hand, alone at last. Total silence. I hear only the voice of complicity. As cold as it is, with you is where I want to be. I want to engage in your story. As the night sets in, my room was filled with gloom. We fell into a dreamless sleep, entwined it in one another's arms. That was our dream.
My poem is about where I'm from. I am from Brockton, where I hear cars, the wind, and animals, where I feel the cold snow and smell food, gas, flowers, and coffee. I'm from the best mom in the world. Well, that's just what I think. What makes her so special is that she is so strong because when my dad pushed her away, she found the strength to get back up. And the crazy thing was that she had three kids and me in her stomach. But she found a new home with four kids. And if she can do that, I think for sure that she is the strongest mom in the world. She loves and helps each of us as if she only had one. And we love her just as much. I'm most happy in my home because I have so much fun and my family is inside. And I am full of dreams and desires because I love to dance and I want to be a vet. I need to become a vet for the sake of helping animals. And my crazy dog, Ozzy, makes me love animals even more. My aspiration in life is to be like my mom. I'm from those who came before me, but I only want to be like my mom.
Thank you. my poem is called I Am From. I am from Cabo Verde, where I hear everything, where I smell the ocean, where I feel free. I am from my mother. She inspires me to be better. She gives me everything I need. She is tall. She is kind. She is my mother. I am from Brockton, where I feel love, where I'm most happy with my family. It's a new home for me because I have a lot of fun and I'm happy. I'm from dreams and desires. My aspiration in life is to be a lawyer. I need to get a good education to become successful. I am from those who came before me.
Better to ourselves. This generation, full of boys claiming they have more girls than this country has states, full of girls showing more skin than a turkey on Thanksgiving, full of people who are so full of themselves they can't keep up with what's true. Now, not everyone in this generation is like this, but the majority of people are. Kids under the age of 12 are learning how to live the thug life before they can even learn their times tables. The number of selfies and posts on Instagram are larger than the number before that percent sign on their math test. Then there's the people who think that material possessions are everything, buying overpriced things like it's their life's aspiration instead of coming to the realization that they're still able to live and function without the subduction of material production. So, here's a tip. Don't fit in. Don't stay in your lane. Be you and only you. Not the you that people want you to be, but the you that you were born to be, because honestly, that's what helped me.
What it is to be a woman, I'm still trying to figure that out. Sucking in my stomach, tying the strings on my dress, around my waist, to look approachable to our men. What is a woman? Tired hands and feet, working stressful to make ends meet. And for what? A position as a CEO we'll never reach for, because a woman would never stand tall enough to run a company, but can stand tall to hold her man when he has no company. What is a woman? The strongest of them all, sucking in her tears because she's afraid to make her fall. And when she is tired, might be viewed as lifeless. But the truth is, she is tired of fighting. But even then, she'd never give up. Insecurities daily eat her up alive. Still before she goes to bed, she lets out a sigh. A sigh of remaining pride to remind herself she's not perfect, but she is a woman. No man will ever understand what it is to be a woman.
Poem is called Love Yourself. You can't make someone love you if they won't, nor can you make them desire you if they don't. There is no way they can make you happy if you're not happy with yourself. So start from the top. If you don't love yourself there, then that's where the problem lies. Therefore, love yourself first. If the inner you isn't appealing to you, why would it be appealing to anyone? Know your worth. No one will if you don't. So treat yourself like a dime. Loving yourself first certainly isn't a crime.
My second poem is called Imagine That. In a world where my thoughts are my only limitations, without a limit, I go wild with my imagination. Stories and stories I heard, her voice sweet as a singing bird. My sweet mother gave me wings to fly, to soar high beyond the sky. The stories you heard from your mother before you went to bed, when you hugged her. Those are the stories you will read to your children. Stories that will ring true, full of laughter and morals too. Inspired by the things I see, so many childhood memories despite the troubles, I live happily. I never let my pen rest easy, creating characters that come to life. In a world I create, my imagination is what dictates. Unrealistic characters that everyone can relate.
My second poem is, Who Am I? Who am I? I am Fogu. I am Praia. Who am I? Badu, Sapajudu. I don't understand. I know who I am. Dara, that's me. You don't need my last name. I'm not Barros or Montero. Simply me, that's who I am.
The percent sign. Problems, problems, problems. Constantly around me, yet invisible to those who surround me. They can't see what I see, feel what I feel, worry as much as I. The reason being me, myself, and I. I keep my words of worry, emotion, and pain locked in a vault made of 100% fear, 100% anxiety, and 100% failure, adding it up to cause 300% more problems. One day, finally, I enter the pin, unlocking the vault, letting out a tsunami of problems whose completion date is way past due. As the vault becomes emptier, I become stronger. I am now able to walk around 100% fear-free, 100% anxiety-free, and 100% failure-free, making me 300% of a worry-free me. I can now get my way, and if not, that's okay. At least I let my frustrations free, and I'm able to be 100% successful like I'm supposed to be.
Loneliness. She's going to the scene to throw away all she used to be, to drown her sorrow 10 feet under, to lie down at the bottom, laying there waiting for her fate, just 10 feet under. The bubble have seized, and her memories have escaped. Floating to the surface of the ocean, her soul flew through the waves and up towards the sky. Then the light went up. Nothing could be seen, except two flashing lights that blew up in the sky and let sad tears of slide.
A room without boundaries, no barriers, just bond. Tied to a ravishing friendship. Whenever those doors open, the guards are down, the hearts are open, and a flow of emotion come pouring out. A room where even the walls are sworn to secrecy. There, we can dare to share our naked truth without judgment or a blank stare. A room where the age doesn't separate us, nor does it define us. Only our stories to unify us. What we bring is our own vision of the world as we see it, and our experience as a teacher. To my girls, your words warm my heart that fills my body with shivers. To me, you are beyond inspiration. You are the reason I believe that dreams are real. We are the Baronesa Project.
Another round of applause, please, for the Baronesa Project. Thank you. Thank you. So, one small note. We have some beautiful programming at the museum, beautiful exhibitions, wonderful workshops. I want you all to partake of them, and also to consider becoming a member of the museum. Your membership powers our programming, and we would love you to join our family and our community. Now, I want to tell you about another family of mine. About 28 years ago, me and six other freshmen started a singing group. And we did so because our intention was to sing music that we loved, to sing music that we were familiar with, and to move and perform the music in a way that was authentic and real to us. We did not intend for it to last 28 years. We did not foresee that. And it's due to the dedication and the talent and the will and the promise of the young students of Yale University that are here today and those that came before that actually forged this family and this legacy. So this group we're about to welcome on the stage is very close to my heart, and I'm very proud to have them here today. I will let them define themselves when they get to the stage. Because we had a conversation last night about self-determination and humanity and race and progress. Conversations that you don't have every day, but I'm proud to say they happen in shades and at Yale, and doing a great part to this group. So I appreciate you. Without further ado, please, everyone, put your hands together for Shades of Yale University.
Nkosi sikeleli Afrika.
Which translates as God Bless Africa and is the national anthem of a free and democratic South Africa. The group actually has been singing since the time of apartheid in solidarity with South Africans. We're about to have a change of pace because we're gonna sing Don't You Worry About a Thing by Stevie Wonder, and today it's going to be soloed by one of our new members, Miles Cameron. But before we proceed, like the Baronessa Project, we thrive off of audience feedback. So if you hear something that you like, you can give us a snap. You can give us a, hit us with a praise wave, hit us with a yas, hit us with a sing. Hit us anything that the spirit moves you to emote, we just feed off of that. So again, thank you so much for coming and enjoy the rest of the show.
All right, how we feeling? No te preocupes, porque tú no estás bien, chévere. ¿Me entiendes? Not worth having, but don't you worry about a thing. And don't you worry about a thing, my mind. Cause I'll be standing on that side when you check it out. Oh, they say the style of life's a drag, and that you must go other places. But darling, don't you feel too bad. You get fooled by smiling faces. Don't you worry about a thing, nah, nah. No, don't you worry about a thing, my mind. Cause I'll be standing on that side when you check it out. When you get don't you worry about that. No, don't you worry about a thing. About a thing, about a thing, about a thing. And listen, everybody needs a change, a chance to check out that newbie. You're the only one to see the changes you take yourself through. Don't you worry about a thing, nah. Don't you worry about a thing, pretty mama. Cause I'll be standing on that side when you check it out. Yeah. Oh, mama, 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 mama. Don't you worry about a thing. No, no, don't you worry about a thing, mama sister. Cause I'll be standing on that side when you check it out. No, don't you worry about a thing. Don't you worry about a thing, about a thing, about a thing, about a thing. Don't you worry about it, don't you worry, don't you worry about it. No, don't you worry about a thank you.
We have Spiritual by one of our favorite groups, Sweet Honey and the Rock, and it's going to be soloed by one of our freshmen, Ashton Tolles. And this song is a modern-day spiritual that speaks of a lot of injustices and struggles from the civil rights era and beyond. And we sing it to give us strength and hope, and we hope it means something to you, too. Thanks.
Can no one know at sunrise how this day is going to end. Can't no one know at sunset if the next day will begin. Help me sing it.
Can no one know at sunrise how these days go to and when? Can no one know at sunset if the next day
do. And if in the desert I'll find pleasure, and if in the valley I really, really don't care, I walk through the wilderness, shadows of darkness, but I'll never falter, no, as long as you're there.
Wherever I go,
oh,
by the Windens called Wherever I Go, today soloed beautifully by Shirley and Nick. Yeah, let's go. Up next we've got Words, originally written and performed by Anthony David and India Ari. Today it's going to be a duet performed by Elof and Drew, so enjoy.
Let me
express to you the way that I feel.
Make this night the best night. Time for second chance. Turn it up on repeat and we can start to dance. Sometimes when we're talking, words get drowned out by the sound. Let's get back to touch and we'll get back on solid ground. Oh, let's hold hands like the young romance. Let's first kiss like the moment we first did. Now can we make love like way back in the day, love? We can lose control, baby, don't say no. Heaven only knows.
Heaven only knows.
Heaven only knows. Heaven only knows. Come back, just come back, baby.
Come back to me.
Heaven only knows. Won't you just come back, baby? Heaven only knows. Heaven, heaven. Heaven only knows.
So what you just heard was Heaven by John Legend, which was soulfully soloed by Abdul. So up next, we will be singing Certainly, which is by one of our favorite artists in Shades, Erica Badu, which will be soloed by Jackie, and it will be amazing, so brace yourselves for that.
Oh, I wanna do, buddy. No, I was not the king for the love that no, no.
I was not looking for the love that no.
Hold me.
Baby, crazy love, crazy love. Everyone, that was Crazy Love, originally by Van Morrison, but we sang it in the style of Brian McKnight, and it was soloed by Galen McAllister. Our next song for you will be Hound Dog, popularized by Elvis Presley, but originally sung by Big Mama Thornton. We hope you all enjoy it. It's going to be soloed by Kaylin Trevia Birchfield.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Been snooping around the door. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Been snooping around the door. You can wag your tail, but I ain't gonna feed you no more.
Round my door, just wait.
lifetime of stability. Anything you wanna be, nothing is impossible for you. There are no words or ways to show my love for all the thoughts I'm thinking of. Cause this life is no good alone. Since we've become one, I've made a change. Everything I do now makes sense. And all roads end. All I do is for you. For you I'd share the cup of love that overflows, and anyone who knows us knows. Oh, I would change all thoughts I have for you. There is no low or high or in between. Of my heart you haven't seen. Cause I'll share all I have and give. Nothing I've said want to understand. All I feel deeper still. That I play, every word I might say, every melody I feel, only for you and your dear. Every word that I write, every day of my life, would not be filled with all the things that my love for you now brings. Now and for eternity. Oh, nothing could replace this vow for you. I give my hand and heart and everything, and I tell them how wedding ring. Cause I'll share all I have been there. Nothing I've said to my understand. If this feeling should leave undone, here's why. All this love is for you.
Ooh.
eyes. When I look in your eyes, I know what you're thinking of. It's a beautiful day and you're welcome to stay.
Welcome to stay.
Spend some time and catch the
passion.
So far ahead, dead as far ahead.
Oh, when we make a fire, we get by with love.
Sky is above.
a dream that I could call my own. I found a thrill to press my cheek to, a thrill that I have never known. You smile, you smile, you smile, you smile, and a spell is cast, and here we are.
Leave me out in the hell.
Tell me, darling, tell me, baby.
Oh,
I just want to give a special, special thank you. First, to two wonderful women that are in the audience. One is Jennifer Madar, and the other is TT. Come up, please. Thank you. And this is on behalf of the Yale Black Alumni Association. We're just so proud of you. These are women who have done the words of the old proverb, planted seeds for trees under shade that they may never get to sit. Jennifer is the president of the Yale Club of Boston. And as far as we know, she's the first Black female president in the 150-year history. And she's doing such a wonderful job with such grace and just such courage, such beautiful leadership. And I'm just so proud of you and all your accomplishments, so thank you. And TT, I loved her even before I met her in person. And we got to plot and scheme on the phone. And when I told her, I ran into your group at the Cultural Center and I told them they needed to come. I just was so pleased to learn that the founder was here. When Shade sang, when I was a Yale freshman, and they sang Jam Tonight, and Sweet Honey in the Rock came from these voices, it was just another affirmation for me that this was my community, this Yale community was mine too. And it made me feel so at home and so welcome. And so this ministry that you do with your voices is just so important. And it just stirred that up in me, just sitting here thinking that still continues for students. And to teach you to know that you founded that, I don't even know how to thank you and to tell you how much that means to me and to all of us. So thank you for that.